RTX 5090. My focus is on how effective this new card will be for programs like Unrealengine, Blender, and Embergen, especially in earlier path tracer rendering. Many of my projects used path tracing, which was incredibly time-consuming even with the RTX 4090. Sometimes, I had to render for an entire month to finish my project. That's why I have been waiting for benchmarks to see how much RTX 5090 can reduce path tracer render times. The benchmarks from Puget Systems were too limited, and since there was not a lot of information out there, I decided to just buy one and test it myself. Getting an RTX 5090 right now needs a lot of luck. In my country, some distributors occasionally have raffles for the RTX 5090, and out of 1500 applicants, only 15 people were able to buy one. I was one of them. Alright, let's dive right into earlier path trace benchmark using RTX 4090 and 5090. Here is my system. For this benchmark, I used two projects I created myself. I will compare the render times, power consumption, and core temperatures when exporting 20 frames from each project in EXR file. First, a project rendering one Metahuman. It's a simple level with just a couple of movable lights and the Metahuman itself. 512 spatial sample, 2 temporal sample, and 20 frames exporting took 22 minutes and 43 seconds on RTX 5090, consuming 420 watts. Under the same setting, RTX 4090 took 37 minutes and 4 seconds using 270 watts. RTX 5090 is 1.6 times faster than RTX 4090, also consumes 1.6 times the power. The second level design I tested was my ambitious project rendering a cellular structure. It is incredibly GPU intensive level, causing significant lag even in the Lumen viewport. The RTX 5090 took 29 minutes and 2 seconds, consuming 530 watts. Under the same settings, RTX 4090 took 40 minutes and 53 seconds, using 380 watts. The RTX 5090 is 1.4 times faster than RTX 4090, but consumes 1.4 times the power. What is interesting here is that even though we use the same rendering method, the rendering speed varied between the two projects. Still, it is clear that the RTX 5090 brings a significant speed boost compared to the RTX 4090. And I tested Embergen VDB Export, but there wasn't a significant difference between the two. The viewport frames with Davinci NR or Dehancer didn't show a notable difference compared to the RTX 4090. Puget Systems already provided benchmarks for Blender cycle rendering. I didn't feel the need to do it myself. RTX 5090 is currently selling at absurd price, but when the price goes down, it will be a very attractive upgrade for someone using path tracer rendering in earlier. So, that's it. Thank you for watching.